Good morning to you, East Texas. Meteorologist Carson Vicroy here. We're tracking the potential of rain after midnight tonight. And yes, everybody's been hyping this up today. We do have the possibility of perhaps a sleet pellet or two or a snow flurry or two that could mix in. I'll show you what's going on across the area right now. This was actually taken at 7 o'clock, so I'm going to go ahead and advance it for you. As you can see, the trend continues. Clouds are pushing into the area. But look at this storm system over the Four Corners region. That's our next weather maker, and it's not going to arrive until after midnight tonight. You have lots of rain over the states of New Mexico and Arizona at the current point. No surprise there, and this is all pushing into our direction as we speak. So I do want to show you futurecast here real quick. As you can see, yes, we do see the clouds. This is midnight. Rain still off to our west, so if you're staying up late tonight, you're not going to notice the rain, assuming you go to bed right after midnight. However, as we get into the very early morning hours for your Wednesday, this does begin to change. We'll pause it there for you at about 3 o'clock in the morning. Our western counties will be the first to see this rain, but for our eastern counties, it's probably not going to arrive until maybe 4, 5, 6 o'clock. So we'll go ahead and advance this once more. And as you can see, at 6 o'clock, there it is. Shaded in the pink from about Cass County down to Marion County, even northern sections of Harrison County. Yes, we do see the potential of a rain-snow mix because the upper atmosphere is much colder than what we're going to see in the lower levels. Now, I do expect temperatures to be in the middle 30s for most locations tomorrow, so we're not going to see any accumulating snowfall. However, the further north you go, the better chance you see of seeing that rain-snow mix. So here's what happens tomorrow afternoon. This is going to turn into a widespread cold rain event, so anything that does fall is going to melt right on impact. And once again, I'm not expecting anything in the way of snowfall accumulations. I am certainly not expecting icy roads. Ground temperatures are just going to be far too warm for that. But what we will see is a lot of light rain. This is noontime, this is lunchtime, so unfortunately the kids will be indoors for recess tomorrow, and you're probably going to want to have that lunch indoors as well. And then we'll take you through the rest of the forecast period. We could have some breaks Thursday night, but as we go to about 10 o'clock Thursday morning, that is when that rain starts to push out of the area. It'll push out of our East Texas counties first, and then deep East Texas counties second. So that's futurecast for you. This is going to be the main story. Here are those rainfall amounts. It's been going back and forth all morning, but generally it's been trending a little more rain. So from Tyler pointing off to the east, that is the best chance of seeing an inch or more of rain, particularly for our eastern counties. That includes east of Smith County, near Gregg County, Ruska County, Shelby County, Panola County, Harrison County, Gregg County, Cass County, from Linden to Longview to Henderson to Marshall. We could very well pick up an inch to an inch and a quarter, and even an inch and a half in some spots. And again, this is through Thursday morning, according to the same model that I just showed you. Now, here is the potential for winter weather. This winter weather line, where we do see the possibility of that snow and sleet mixing in with the rain, it has moved off to the north just a little bit, as you can see right there, to the north of I-20. That is the best chance of seeing that rain-snow mix. Again, not expecting any snowfall accumulations because temperatures are going to be far too warm for that. For deep East Texas, I'm sorry, kiddos, you're just going to see a cold rain event at this point. Again, the best window for seeing this will be between about 3 o'clock in the morning and 7 o'clock in the morning. So we'll continue to keep an eye on that, on this, just in case if something were to change. Now, temperatures right now, it's still cold if you're heading outside this morning. Temps are in the middle to upper 30s along I-30. A little further down to the south, we're slightly warmer. It's 39 in Tyler, 39 noonday, 37 is the current reading in Jacksonville, 39 for Cherokee County Airport, and 39 in Rusk. Deep East Texas is a little warmer. We don't have as many clouds in the area, so that's why. It's 42 in Lufkin, 43 is the current reading in Huntington. So, bottom line, if you think you're going to see snow tomorrow, which you probably won't in deep East Texas, but if you're along and north of I-20, yes, I can't rule out the possibility of a snow flurry or a sleet pellet or two mixing in with that rain. No accumulations, no impact to travel, but we will see wet roadways in the morning, so prepare for that. You may want to leave a little extra, or you may want to leave earlier than you normally would. 10 to 15 minutes will probably do you. We'll continue to keep you updated throughout the day.